Hey everybody, how you doing? This is about to be a really fun video. Out at the range today with heavy metal, and I brought out my 4570. This is my Marlin model 1895, and recently a bunch of you guys said you wanted to see a deer hunt filmed with 4570. So some of my deer hunting, you know, we can shoot 200-300 yards, and iron sights, I don't feel confident taking that far of a shot. Inside 100, iron sights, sure, with a red dot, sure, but 200, 300, that's a little bit of a stretch. So, what I did, I got a rail on here, I got one of these LPVOs on here, low power variable optic, and depending on the outcome of today, we might shoot a deer with this Marlin, but yeah. I haven't shot this enough to have confidence, like I said, with the iron sight, so we put on a scope with it, and we're going to get the scope sighted in, get a little bit of practice, and see if we feel comfortable or have the confidence taking a deer with it. The ammo we got out here today is some Winchester Super X 300 grainers. I have got to give a big shout out to the sponsor of the video. They hooked us up with that ammo in a time when I can't find 4570 ammo anywhere, so the only way literally we can film this video is because Bad Dobby hooked us up. Let me tell you a little bit about Bad Dobby. You guys go check them out and tell them Whoteewho said hey.
A big thanks goes to Bad Dobby's Pet Store, friends of ours, for helping sponsor today's video. They've got American-made quality treats for your furry friends. They've got all kind of toys, collars, anything you could think of for your pet. They're going to have it. Go check out their website. Tell them Whoteewho sent you. Appreciate y'all supporting the people and the good folks that help to support us. Y'all go check out baddobbyspetstore.com.
But we really appreciate them. Like I said, I appreciate you supporting the people who support us. So y'all go check out Bad Dobby. But I'm going to laser bore sight this real quick. And because we only have 20 bullets, I don't have a reserve of bullets of this. We're going to really be careful about our laser bore sighter. Probably take a shot maybe at 30 yards and go back to 100. I like to sight everything in at 100. Be real careful about it. We got 20 bullets to get this right, and we need to have some left over for deer hunting. So check it out. I'm going to put the laser in there, get her close, and then we're going to take some shots and sight this in. Hopefully a quick video. All right, so I'm going to tell you exactly what I did. Heard my excursion there. Heard my wife's excursion. Down there, right there, that's 30 yards away at some paper plates. I laser bore sighted this at 10 yards, 2 inches low. Maybe I could have laser bore sighted it back here, but I think that's going to get us kind of close here at 30. I'm going to take one shot, show you guys where the hit is, and then we're going to go towards back to 100 if our shot makes any sense. 4570. All right, so let me zoom you guys in where that hit. Almost dead on at 30 yards. So that means we're probably going to be high at 100. So I'm going to click down just a little bit, and then we'll go back to 100 and take a shot quick. Whew. All right, now we're back at 100. And so that first shot at 30 was pretty much dead on. I made a couple adjustments. Now we're going to take a shot at 100. I've only got 3 bullets in here because I'm halfway confident that we can get this baby sighted in. Let's see where this hits. Maybe high. If anything, I think it's probably going to be high. But let's see where she hits here. 100 yards. Failed to mention too, this is an Athlon Argos LPVO. It's got 8 zoomies in it. So I did have this on my 300 blackout. Then I needed another scope, so I robbed it from my 300 blackout and put a red dot on the 300. But let's see where this hits. I'm going to shoot that same bottom plate that has a hole near the center. Just see where we're at 100 here. These Marlins have a safety button on them. Wow, so that hit low and right. How in the devil does that make sense? This baby's torqued on good. I know that for a fact. I don't play around anymore when it comes to torquing things. Yeah, we got no slop in the scope. So let me make some more adjustments here. All right, so I had to do something real quick, but I did grab that box while I was down there. So we got two more in the gun. I think my adjustments ought to be pretty good. All I did was left it in the rest and adjusted the scope to where that last hole was. So we should be pretty close. Let's see what happens. Just about dead on there at 100. So I'm gonna give it just a click, two clicks right. Now we're gonna go up to a clean plate, shoot that top one, and if we hit the middle, then we should be golden. And I'm actually gaining some confidence real quick in this. So safety and raise this baby up to the top plate. Let's see where she hits. See if this setup's gonna hold zero for us on the beast. I'd say we're good. That's an inch high at 100. We're good. I'm calling that sighted in. I love this setup. So I've shot this with iron sights with a red dot. This is my favorite 45-70 setup I have ever shot. So yeah, we're ready to go. That video turned out even better than I expected. Like I said in the beginning of the video, 45-70 ammo, it's hard to come by right now. And if you do find it, big money. If you don't shoot 45-70, before all these crazy times, at Walmart, this was $42. So normal, even cheap Walmart prices, these are over $2 a pop. So again, we really appreciate Bad Dobby. Y'all go check them out after this video. But a little bit of the stats. So we sighted that in about an inch high at 100. Look at the stats there. So this is saying if you sight it in at 100, it drops 12 inches. So if I see a deer at 200 yards, which is a possibility, obviously, the holdover on that needs to be about 10 or 11 inches. Actually, I forgot to show you the plates. We got to show you the plates up close. But yeah, 200. Hey, I'm confident in that sucker now. This was our 30-yard shot, then our first 100-yard shot. Then we made an adjustment and hit there, made another adjustment, and then hit right there. So, hey, that's money right there. And I can tell you right now, I have never been more confident in this rifle. I have now fallen back in love with the 45-70. But, hey, tell me what you think about it. I know there's a lot of old school folks that say lever guns should be for iron sights, but hey, especially when I'm hunting, I like to talk about precision. You know, I'm going to shoot the deer right there, and I'll know exactly where it's going to hit. With this scope on this, I know exactly where I'm going to hit that deer. I'm going to tell you before I pull the trigger. With iron sights, past 100 yards, at least without my eyeballs and experience, it's kind of like, I'm pretty sure I'm going to hit him right there, but my groups are probably going to be about the size of a baseball with iron sights, which is fine for hunting too, but hey, we got that laser precision now with this LPVO setup. But I could ramble on all day about this rifle. Absolutely love it. Let me know what you think about the 45-70. Also, while I'm thinking about it, shout out to Alfred. Alfred sent us in the limbsavers. I appreciate you, man, but we'll see y'all in the next one. Comment down below ideas you want to see for the 45-70. I think we still got like 16 more bullets. See y'all in the next one. Hootie hoo. Load it up and get it all as soon as you can. 30-06 to like